Declare his glory among the heathens, his wonders among all people. For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Give unto the Lord, all ye kindreds of the people. Give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Oh, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. May the Lord add a blessing through the reading and the hearing of his word and sanctify these truths in our hearts. God bless you. You may be seated. I'm excited about giving God some praise, giving God some honor, giving God some accolades and acknowledgement because he's worthy of everything.
Amen.
You don't have to debate. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to figure if it's all right. The Bible says in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. So I can thank him over and over again, and even if I get tired, God still deserves more thanksgiving.
Bye.
And I'm glad that I can praise him in such a time and in such a place and in such an era and in such a space that God gives us to give him some glory. Oh God, I thank you. See, you got to get to the point that it's no more I, but it's Christ that lives in me. And when it's Christ that lives in you, nothing else matters but the glory. Nothing else matters but giving him some praise and honor because he's worthy of it all. Small, great, or large, God is worthy of all praise. He's worthy of all honor. He's worthy of all acknowledgement. When I lift up his name, I'm not making a mistake. When I give him praise, it's not unjustified. It is his because he deserves it. Everything belongs to God. And because God is sovereign, oh, I give him praise and thanksgiving. God is a good God. If I might use for a word this morning, I thank the Lord. As I was sitting there, the choir was singing and the songs and the praise and all that we have done thus far this morning have been a crescendo, if you will, to the glory and to the presence of God. It has elevated in my spirit just how good, glory to God. You got to think about how good God is.
Amen.
And when you think about how good God is, I heard a preacher say one time, five things about God. He's good, 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 good. Amen. He said, I can't describe him otherwise. He's good. And because he's good, I can give him praise and honor and don't have to be weary, don't have to wonder whether it's deserved. If I give him praise, he's worthy of all honor and praise. Oh God, I thank you for who you are. But my useful word this morning would be his excellent greatness. His excellent greatness. Now, if I talk about somebody's greatness, you might think of a figure in history or even a figure in our time who declares himself to be great. But when I add his excellent greatness, there can only be one God, who's excellent and great is our God. He's worthy of all praise. There's none like him, none compared to him. He's God all by himself. We sing songs. We quote scripture about the person and the character of God because we love God. We give him praise. We give him admonishment because we want God to know that we are pleased to know him. We are pleased to give him some glory. We use words like awesome. We use words like holy. And God knows we use words like mighty, because God is a mighty God. And he's worthy of our praise. David put it like this. He concluded in Psalms 48:1, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised.
Yes, yes.
In the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. As I was sitting there and I read that scripture, I was kind of looking over, being prompted by the Holy Ghost. The Lord said, when you read that scripture, you got to get a visual of how God is. It says, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. His very nature demands praise. His very presence is holy and glorious and can be nothing less. And then the Lord said, look at Isaiah. I just want to read this to kind of give you a visual of the mountain of holiness and the greatness of God as we see him in his glory. Isaiah 6:1 says this. Says in 6:1, in the year that King Uzziah, this is the prophet Isaiah who was writing, he said, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord also sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. I'm talking about in the mountain of his holiness, in his greatness, in his glory. Isaiah said, listen, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. He was high, he was lifted up, and he said his train filled the temple. Get a picture of this. He said above it stood seraphims, and each one had six wings, and twain he covered his face, and with twain he covered his feet, and with twain he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, holy, holy, mountain of his holiness, oh God, I thank you. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory, and the posts of the door moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. I'm talking about the mountain of his holiness, his presence, his glory. But David said, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. Isaiah said, I seen it. I seen glory, I seen smoke, I seen presence. I saw all that God is in a vision. Woo, glory. God, I thank you for your presence. I thank you for your power. Oh, great God that he is. When God spoke to Moses on Mount Horeb in Exodus 3, he spoke and he let him know who he was. Because God can't be identified with somebody else. He's God all by himself. And I'm glad about it. I'm glad there's one God and Father of all who is mighty, and we can call him by name. Oh, great God that he is. Bible says in Exodus 3:14, and God said unto Moses, I am that I am. Mm-hmm. And he said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am have sent me unto you. God said, listen, there's none like me. I'm God all by myself. I'm the self-existent one. I'm who I am because I'm God. And then in the Amplified Bible, the same verse reads as this. And God said to Moses, I am who I am and what I am. And I will be what it will be. And he said, you shall say to this Israelite, I am have sent me to you. God is identified by who he is, and there's glory in his name, there's glory in his presence, there's glory in the fact that God is glorious. When God begins to move in your life, expect the glory. When God begins to do what he has promised, expect the work of God nonetheless. God's going to do what he has to do. God don't need you. He don't need me. God can do it all by himself. But because he created us, God has given us opportunity to bask in his glory and in his presence and know that he is excellent in his greatness. His excellent greatness. There's no diminishing of his will. There's no diminishing of his power. There's no diminishing of who he is. Ooh, glory, the names of God, it's himself. Invoke his oneness and his sovereignty. His very name itself. When he said, I am that I am, nobody else can bear that name but God.
My.
Oh, God, I thank you. He's Elohim. He's Jehovah. He's Adonai. He's El Shaddai. He's Jehovah Jireh. He's Jehovah Ropi. He's Jehovah Nissi. He's Jehovah Mekanesh. He's Jehovah Shalom. He's Jehovah Tiskanu. He's Jehovah Rohi. He's Jehovah Shalom. God said, listen, there's nobody like me. Woo, glory. I'm God all by myself. I'm excellent in my greatness. I'm sovereign.
Amen.
I'm sovereign. Ooh, glory. You can't stand in the same place he stands unless he allows you. You can't be in his presence unless he affords you grace to come in it. Ooh, God, I thank you. That's why it's so special and such a blessing that the Holy Ghost is given to us who believe. So we can have a foretaste of the glory that is and only belongs to God.
Amen.
Woo, glory. That's why the Bible says, if any man hath not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. Because that identifies me with his presence. Glory. I can go into a dark room and still sense the presence of God. I can be in a place that I've never been before and still sense the presence of God. Why? Because he said he'd never leave me nor forsake me. He's in front of me, he's behind me, he's around me, he's all in, oh glory, where I need to be, because God is everywhere at all times. I am that I am. His excellent greatness. He's sovereign. He's sovereign. Oh God, I thank you for your word. Jesus in the New Testament embodies the fullness of the Godhead bodily. Folk have a problem with trouble with Jesus, but Jesus is the fullness of the Godhead bodily. The Bible says in Philippians 2 and 9, wherefore God hath highly exalted him, meaning Jesus, and given him a name, glory be to God, which is above every name. Nobody can, listen, nobody can have a name that's above every name except it be God.
Yes, yes.
Then he says that at the name of Jesus,
every
knee shall bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. And what is interesting is, if at the name of Jesus only things on earth responded, then he really wouldn't be God, because he'd have to be sovereign over everything.
Amen.
But the Bible says whatever's beneath, glory to God, whatever's above, whatever's in heaven, whatever's in the earth, because of his name, everything's going to bow because he's sovereign.
Amen.
Excellent greatness.
Yes.
Woo, glory. We're not serving a God on a mantle. We're not serving a God that's made of wood, hay, or stubble. We're serving a God that's eternal and infinite and able because he has excellent greatness. We serve a God that has to be feared. We serve a God that demands reverence. His very presence is worth the glory. His very presence is worth the praise. You know, old folks used to say, if I could just wave my hand, because I just want to give him some glory.
Yes, one.
Some thanksgiving he has yet to receive. He's worthy of a hand praise. He's worthy of a clap off.
Yes.
He's worthy of me opening my mouth and saying hallelujah to his name.
Anyhow.
He's great all by himself. Oh, God, he said that everything under the earth and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. His excellent greatness is his because he's sovereign.
Amen. Amen.
Ooh, Lord, what can you do that God don't know about? What can you say that God hasn't already heard? He's sovereign. Glory to God. Look at our text here. I love this. David, I love it. You know, God used David mightily. Because I believe that as Isaiah was a prophet, I believe David had the ministry, a prophetic ministry, because there's no way in the world that David could have pinned down such words except God pinned it through him. There's no way in the word that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And things such as that, give God some glory, give him some praise. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. No way in the world he could have come up with it from his head. It had to come from the unction, woo, glory, of the greatness and the glory of God. But David, again, is giving God some praise he rightly deserves. Amen. He says, listen, sing unto the Lord a new song. He says, sing and bless his name. Show forth his salvation day by day. He said, declare his glory among the people, among the heathens. He said, for the Lord is when you consider man today and looking at people who declare themselves to be great, when you start talking about you great, then you're really not great, because the witness ought not to come from you. Amen. But the Bible says that when God couldn't find any witness, he made a witness in himself. When he couldn't get an amen, glory to God, he amened himself.
Amen.
His excellent grace. He's, oh, nobody going, amen, that's all right, amen. And it was worth the glory. Glory, glory, glory. Look at this now. David says, listen, the Lord is great, greatly to be praised and to be feared above all gods, small g. But the Lord is a capital L, meaning the Lord of glory, meaning the sovereign God of the universe. Our Lord, there's nobody greater than him. He said he's above all other gods, small g. He's above all them that are insignificant, that are man-made, that could never stand the test of time, because God is infinite and all-powerful.
Yes.
Ooh, his excellent greatness. When God brought the Israelites through the Red Sea and did a miraculous work and told Moses, what you got in your hand, raise it up. And when Moses lifted up his hand, the very sea parted. And the Bible said they walked over on dry land. Ooh, don't tell me God ain't excellent. God said, listen, I made the seas. I made the earth. I made the islands. All I got to do is speak of it, and it has to respond. And the Bible declares that they walked over on dry land. And such was the celebration that the Bible says that when they walked over the Red Sea, Miriam began to praise God in song. Yeah. Because she recognized that which was done could not have been accomplished except for his excellent greatness among us.
Amen.
Look what it says here in Exodus 15 and 20. And Miriam the prophetess, I love that they called her a prophetess, because it wasn't too much longer they were scolding Miriam. But God said, oh no, I'll use whom I will. And God grabbed her and allowed the excellent word to come out of her mouth. And the Bible declares, she said, listen, the sister of Aaron took a timbrel in her hand, and all the women went out after her with timbrel and with dances. And Miriam answered them, sing ye to the Lord, for he hath triumphed gloriously. Excellent greatness. The horse and his rider he hath thrown into the sea.
Yes.
Ooh, glory. She said, God has triumphed gloriously. His excellent greatness, because he's sovereign. That's why you ought to thank him anyhow. You might not be able to think about what he's done, but when you think for a minute, you ought to yet say, Lord, I thank you for who you are.
Amen.
Ooh, God, I thank you for who you are. Back to our text here. It says here, for all the gods of the nations are idols. It talks of the insignificance of them that try to be other, be gods to them that don't know God. He said all of them are idols. He said, but the Lord made the heavens. The idols didn't make a thing. The idols were made by man and have no power at all. He said, honor and majesty are before him, meaning God's strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Give unto the Lord all ye kingdoms. Give unto him glory and strength. Oh, his excellent greatness. Give the Lord the glory. Do his name. Oftentimes you can be in a house or in a service or amongst a company of believers and folk get to talking about how good God is. And you find yourself preoccupied with the memory of how good God has been. And you just can't sit still. Even in a service, somebody might say, I couldn't sit down any longer. I had to tell you how good God has been. The psalmist said, give God the glory. Do his name. I don't know about you, but you may not testify. You may not open your mouth. You may be more resolved to just sit, but every now and then, glory to God, there ought to be a praise in your spirit enough to give God some glory. Do his name. Somebody said, well, I ain't emotional. It's interesting that you can get emotional over natural things, but can't get emotional over spiritual things that help you maintain what you got naturally. But every now and then, there ought to be a Lord, I thank you. You've been good. God, I may not be where I like to be. Glory to God. But because of your excellent greatness in my life, because you're sovereign, God, how good you've been. We sung the song, thank him anyhow. Regardless of your situation and circumstance, God, I thank you.
Yes.
Ooh, glory. Look at this now. David goes on. He says, oh, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. And I read that text in Isaiah 6. And Isaiah was caught up in a vision, saw the presence of God, the power of God. The glory was such that the post inside the sanctuary, inside the presence, moved at the voice. Glory to God. God spoke his voice and the post moved. Then the Bible says in that fifth verse that Isaiah said, listen, what I'm seeing, I'm not even qualified to see. He said, I'm undone. See, one thing about being in God's presence, one thing about experiencing his excellent greatness is that there's a wave of humility to let me know that all I can give him is reverence. I can't be proud in his presence. I can't be lifted up in his presence. God, all I can give you is some glory you have yet to receive. Isaiah said, I can't even open my mouth. And the Bible said the angels came and put hot coals on his tongue so that he could speak a prayer.
Yes.
Ooh, God, I thank you that you sent angels to put hot coals on my tongue so that I could give you glory that you have yet to receive. Ooh, glory. God, I thank you for your praise. All right. God's greatness, his excellent greatness, is absolute in power, in praise, in presence, and in person.
Thank you, Lord.
In power, in praise, in presence, and in person. Glory to God. Absolute in power. Woo, glory, because he's great. Psalms 147:5 says this, great is the Lord. And of great power, his understanding is infinite. Excellent greatness, great power. Bible says in Psalm 62:11, God has spoken once, twice have I heard this, that power belongeth, oh God, that's great, unto God.
Yes.
Ooh, glory. Ooh, excellent, great. It's absolute. God has all power his excellent greatness, ooh, because he's sovereign.
Yeah.
All power, not only in power, but in praise. Ooh, God, I thank you for your word. God, I thank you for your word. He's mighty, he's able in praise. Oh, God, I thank you. He's excellent in praise, he's sovereign. Ooh, Psalms 145:3 says, listen, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness, look at this now, is unsearchable. In other words, what God can do and what God is able to accomplish, you can't find out because there's no limit to what God is. Glory to God.
Yes.
He excels at everything.
Yes,
his excellent greatness. Woo, God, I thank you. Psalms 115:2 says, listen, praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness.
Yes.
Woo, if you don't have anything else to praise him, God, I praise you because you're great all by yourself. I praise you because you're God all by yourself. Not only in praise, but in presence. In presence, God is great. Jeremiah 10:6 says this, for as much as there is none like unto thee, O Lord, thou art great, and thy name is great in might. In other words, he said, in presence, there's none like me. I'm mighty all by myself. I'm great. You know how some folk think they're wonderful? That's really a figment of their imagination. But God is great all by himself, and we have to reverence his presence as well as we reverence his person.
Yes, thank you.
Woo, you can't take nothing away from his testimony. You know how somebody will give a testimony, and you'll say, you put a question mark after it.
Yes.
Because a testimony has to have a testifier. And if you testify to your testimony and it doesn't line up, there's some question. But when God makes testimony of who he is, there's no gaps, there's no cracks. He's great all by himself.
All by himself.
Oh, God, I thank you for your presence. The Bible says in Psalms 48:1, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. His presence is great. It's excellent because he's God. Even in the Lord's Prayer, the B portion of the 6th chapter of Matthew, the 13th verse, the B portion says this, for thine is the kingdom. Woo, thank you for your presence. And the power and the glory forever. Amen. The only one that could say Selah or amen or bring conclusion to ending what is a testimony to who he is God. For thine is the power, the glory, glory, God. Woo, God. Why? Because he's God. Thine is the power, the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Amen. Nothing after,
nothing
before. He said, listen, I'm the first and the last. I'm the beginning and the end.
Yes.
Woo, I'm the same. Yes, glory, God. Yesterday, today, excellent greatness. Same yesterday, today, and forever. He's sovereign. His greatness, his presence is excellent. Not only is he absolute in presence, absolute in praise, absolute in power, he's absolute in person.
Amen.
His person alone is absolute. He said, listen, there's none beside me. Isaiah 43:11. I, even I, am the Lord, and beside me, there is no other. I have declared, have saved, I have showed, when there was no strange God among you. Therefore, you are my witnesses, saith the Lord. I am God.
Thank you, Lord.
My very person declared who I am. There's none like, when I showed up, glory to God. You got to get this. When God showed up in your life, yes, there was no comparison to him.
Amen.
He said, my very person let you know this is God, the sovereign God, and there's none. Oh, God, thank you. Like my excellent greatness. You couldn't copy me. You couldn't compare me to nobody. You can't listen. You walk away talking about, I've seen God. He said, because there's none. My very person convinced you that there's none. Oh, God, I thank you. Like me. That's why the Bible tells us in the fourth chapter of Hebrews, if we have a problem, if we have a situation, he said, come boldly to the throne of grace that you might obtain mercy and help and grace in the time of need. We have not a high priest that can be hidden, that has entered into the heavens, but for the sake of being sovereign in our lives.
Thank you.
His excellent greatness. Woo, glory, glory, absolute in person. The Bible says in James 1 and 17, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down from the Father of light, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. God said, listen, when I come in my full might. I come in my full power. If I release something in your life, it's not going to change. It's for the purpose of me getting the glory out of you. He said there's no shadow of turning. You can't wonder if I knew what I was doing. I knew what I was doing. There's no failing. There's no, listen, there's no hesitation. He said, listen, there's no shadow of turning. I change not. He said, I'm the Lord. And if I released it in your life, is for the purpose of my glory being shown forth in your life because of my excellent greatness.
Yes,
ooh, it's not just a little talk with Jesus. It's a holy communion with the sovereign God of the universe. Oh God, I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
That's why he said, if you need me, call me. If there's a concern, he said, just open your mouth.
Yes.
Oh, glory. God, I know you're sovereign. I know you look down on men. I know you're over everything. God, have mercy. Do you realize when you ask the sovereign God to have mercy, you release all the mercy that's available to us in heaven on our behalf? Bible says mercy endureth forever. God says, so whatever you stand in need of, when you acknowledge my excellent greatness, be prepared for not only my power, my presence, my praise, but my authority in your life.
Amen.
As you put your trust in me. Last scripture here, which was our key verse, Psalms 96 and 4. For the Lord is great.
Yes.
And greatly. I don't know how to do that other than by the Holy Ghost. I don't know how to greatly praise God other than opening my mouth and saying, Lord, have mercy.
Thank you, Lord.
God, thank you.
Thank you.
I don't understand it, but I just got to thank you.
Yes, thank
glory
you.
To God. Be praised. He is to be feared. Above all, God, I reverence who you are, and I thank you for the praise. I thank you for the power. I thank you for the presence. And I thank you for your person, your handiwork in my life, because you walk in excellent greatness. Oh God, for me, through me, oh God, and for the purpose of your glory being shown in my life. God, I thank you. Oh, God, I'm glad he's gracious. You see a book called where he sit high and look low. But God has allowed us to embrace who he is by the Holy Ghost. So he's not sitting high and looking low. He's on the inside springing forth glory.
Thank you.
And so therefore I can say, Abba Father, and call him Daddy. Mm-hmm. His excellent greatness is displayed in my life. Ooh, glory. He chose me. He's making me. Thank you, God, for your excellent greatness
my Lord.
In my life. God bless you.
Thank
God bless
you.